Radiant team.
Right, better get started. Alright, today is the first game of the HCon's Dota 2 Casual Cup will be the Wolves Express versus Jim and the Four Ducklings. So this is now on to the second round of matches. This is upper bracket second round. I will be casting. I'm Zambrella, and with me is Hisley Harriet. I don't know whether he's here now, but he'll be here shortly.
I am indeed.
He's here.
And the troll is banned, I'm so happy.
The troll. Get rid of the troll. And they have a TA as well. This is kind of an interesting first ban, but maybe they just really don't like about it. They know someone on Jim and the Four Ducklings is strong on TA, so who knows. Juggernaut also being banned out by Jim and the Four Ducklings. I guess this is pretty standard. He is a strong hero at the moment. 10 seconds. And we are awaiting the nerf stick to thwack some of these heroes.
5 seconds. Yeah, I just wonder if the Wolves have just done a little bit of research on Jim and the Four Ducklings. I mean, I'm not sure, but yeah, TA is definitely a bit of a weird ban, especially in the first phase.
Well, and then we get the Axe ban as well. They took a little while deliberating this, but I'm not lying, I think I would definitely choose that. Lion, tier 1 support, definitely. It's the first pickup by Wolves Express. I guess we should give a little background. So, the Wolves Express played against, just let me find out, teams of Synergy yesterday, where they narrowly won. Teams of Synergy were definitely ahead, but with a Rapier on a Medusa, dropped by the Ember Spirit, I think it was, who was on the other team, they actually managed to win the game. Or did they buy the Rapier?
The Ember brought the Rapier and then almost instantly lost it in the next fight.
But from
what I remember, I think it was Captain King on his Lion was one of the things that saved them in that game, I think, and kept them going with on-point Earth Spikes and quick Hexes.
I think he was our MVP of the game, but as we can see, Jim the Four Ducklings maybe weren't watching that or just don't care. And they've picked up the Bane Morana combo. Pretty disgusting. But strong, so why not pick it up?
Yeah, it's very powerful if they can obviously get the combo off, but if they start roaming around, they don't get the kills, then, and if we get quick TPs from Lion and the now picked up Witch Doctor, the ganks could go wrong. They'll be underleveled, have no items.
Yeah. So we see the first two picks from both teams are probably the support heroes. So that's pretty interesting. And now on to the second phase of bans. I mean, what else was pretty strong? I wonder whether the Wolves Express, having success with their Medusa in the first game, will want to pick up this in their now second round match. I think we've got another three games coming tonight. Two games after this. I'm not sure how many of those I will be casting, but I'm hoping this one will be a very interesting match, because I think two out of the three games yesterday were also... two out of the three games yesterday were very interesting. There was meant to be four games, but one team did show up. So, come on. Good Dota today, guys, and this will be fun.
Wolves Express looks like they're setting up something for their mid, banning out the Lina and the Invoker, both fairly high nuking heroes.
Maybe they want to pick up the SF, maybe, who is a little susceptible being quite squishy. Reserve time.
Yeah, I think Shadow Fiend is... I mean, obviously Lion's quite a big counter to him, and they've already got him on their side, so...
And Slark banned out. Pretty strong hero.
It's going to be interesting to see what Jim and the Four Ducklings pick up, because obviously they're going to have basically three lanes being soloed with a Bane and Morana running around. So they're going to need pretty survival heroes in their off lane and their safe lane. And they have banned the Shadow Fiend.
They banned the Shadow Fiend.
Which we were talking about.
Maybe they thought the same thing, or maybe they just didn't like the Shadow Fiend because he is a strong hero. Now the pickups. I mean, what else combos quite well with Bane Morana? They might think about the Void. Although, last game we casted, that didn't seem to work out so well. 10 seconds. Wait, was that last game?
Yes, I think it might have been.
All these games blur together.
You never know, there might be a Pudge player on Jim in the Four Ducklings.
And the Spirit Breaker. This is just... This roaming... they're loving this roaming idea. And if Wolves Express don't have the sort of like the wards up or the vision, things could get a little messy if they're not too careful.
Yeah, it looks like Jim and the Four Ducklings. This is probably going to be an offlane Spirit Breaker. They're throwing a lot into mid early game at the moment.
Yeah, and did they run Tidehunter last time? There was a Tidehunter somewhere.
Maybe, but yeah, Tidehunter is very good. It's like disengage from fights, or even the initiation is very strong.
I think the initiation Tidehunter, and then that stun to allow the Witch Doctor ulti to go off for at least a couple of seconds is definitely good. And Tidehunter being extremely tanky, especially with Kraken Shell, might be able to prevent some of the ganks from Bane and Morana yielding a kill.
Yeah, something that's quite good about the Kraken Shell on Tide is he can obviously purge off the max stun arrow if he gets hit by it by Morana, so he can just walk away and
maybe attack a chunk of the health, but he's alive, so he's not going to be too upset about that. Drow
Ranger. Radiance pick. The Drow. I think this is quite a nice pickup for them, especially if Bane and Morana running around. They're both ranged heroes. It gives them a bit of extra power.
Yep.
Although she is very susceptible when once Lion gets his Blink Dagger to just be jumped, hexed, and then blown up.
Yeah, if she's not careful. It's quite common to pick up a Mom as well now, a Drow Ranger, so that'll make her super squishy. But Drow Ranger, I think this is a pretty smart pickup because both Morana and Bane, already both hit fairly hard anyway. The extra damage due to the Drow Aurora will definitely help them with her, keeping whoever they need to back out of the lane.
This is I feel like they could have possibly not banned the Shadow Fiend and picked that up instead of the Spirit Breaker, as he works very well with Drow as well.
Yeah,
and
that's true.
Bane can set up for raises and his ult. But perhaps they just don't like playing him, and
yeah, I mean, at this level, not everyone can play everything, so maybe they don't have an SF player. So fair enough, ban it out if you don't like it. Now the Wolves Express got about a minute here to pick up their fourth hero. Either they need a carry or a mid hero. Be interesting to see what they want to go with. Strong mid heroes still are Puck still left in the pool. Maybe they want to pick up Puck.
Storm is still in there.
I think Storm would actually be, well, I think it'd be alright. I mean, there's a silence from Drow Ranger.
I think Storm will be very strong in this at the moment. After level 6. Until level 6, the Bane and Morana will very easily be able to come rotate and keep killing him, as there is no escape for him.
If this Drow Ranger is mid, they could run a pretty aggressive tri-lane with the Bane, Morana and Spearbreaker.
Yeah, that's not out of the question. It'd be
interesting to see anyway.
Yeah, because obviously Spirit Breaker is someone that can just be left alone if they want to rotate.
So yeah, 10 seconds, 5 seconds now left for Wolves Express to pick him. They picked the Magnus. They're going wombo combo here. I quite like this. I imagine it's a mid-Magnus. Obviously with the Witch Doctor and Tidehunter, this can lead to some extreme damage if the ultimates are combined together properly.
10 seconds. Yeah, well, I mean, just gotta hope that at some point in the game, Lion gets his ags with the RP.
Yeah. I think that would be I think that's more an afterthought. It'd be impressive. I'm not saying it can't be done, but it'll be interesting. I think it'll be.
It's always satisfying when it happens, though.
Oh yes.
But yeah, Mag is another person that will be picking up a blink, so can get in there with the Drow Ranger, preventing her marksmanship or.
Positioning now for Drow Ranger in this game is going
to
be
bringing
important.
The fight to her rather than allowing her to sit at the back.
Yep. And the final ban coming from Jim and the Four Ducklings is the PA. She's pretty good at jumping on the Drow Ranger, so I can kind of understand that. And in a man fight, PA absolutely destroys Drow Ranger. In a 1v1 situation, anyway. And Wind Ranger, the last ban for Wolves Express. Interesting.
Oh, yes. I think it's quite good because Power Shot can obviously work with Nightmare from Bane, and her ultimate with Drow Aura is quite disgusting.
That would definitely be strong. And I guess the shackles, if you're sat far enough back, can definitely disjoint the combo if you're quick enough.
We all know the shackles that can bend around corners.
Yeah, at like 90 degrees. These perpendicular shackles. Reserve time. So 50 seconds left to pick up the last hero. I imagine they're going to be looking for a mid hero, unless they're planning to run the Drow Ranger mid, which isn't very common at the moment. But I'm not going to say it's not going to happen.
Yeah, no, yeah. Drow should have a fairly okay time in the safe lane, even if she's just soloing against a Tide.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, doesn't have to worry about the minus damage via Anchor Smash. And yeah, there's the puck. This is the initiation that I need. I mean, Spirit Breaker is an okay initiator, but say they get a Yules or something, that's it. It's not going to happen. But I don't see any heroes on this team that sort of. I think Spirit Breaker gets countered extremely hard by Yules, especially if he doesn't preemptively. Well, first farm up a BKB and then preemptively cast it.
Something I quite like about using Spirit Breaker is obviously the charge gives vision, so that allows space for perhaps the puck to see what they're going to jump onto, or even for Morana arrows.
And the anti-mage pick. So yeah, this is a Maid Magnus, must be a safe lane anti-mage, coupled with Lion and Witch Doctor supporting him, and an offlane Tidehunter. And this is going to be the first game of tonight, so I'm very much looking forward to this one. I hope it's lots of fun for everyone watching.
Yeah, it seems like this is kind of what Wolves Express did in their last game. They had a lot of potential to teamfight during the mid-game to keep them going, and then they just had their Medusa, in this case an anti-mage, to come through at the end and out-carry the other team if they can just sit there and turtle long enough, even if they lose towers.
Yeah, and definitely something to mention is Captain King is not playing on the Lion.
Yeah, there's been a change-up.
Unless they're going to swap over later on, which I doubt. Oh, we're remaking the game.
Well, we seemed to have this problem yesterday.
Yeah. Let's disconnect from this game then. We leave the game? Yeah?
Yep, my name is Red. That's quite fancy.
Okay, well, this is happening. I'm actually gonna go to the loo.
I'm gonna go grab a drink. I'll be back in one sec.
I'm ready. Are you ready? Luke, you there? Alright, looks like we're going in. This is a remake. So an all-pick remake, so now everyone has to remember what everyone picked, which can be a little tricky at times.
Mirana.
Tide. Spirit.
I have returned.
Alright, good. So everyone's picking up their heroes now, after the remake. This is an all-pick remake.
This is where one of the teams makes secretly, a cheeky last minute change.
What's the last hero? Anti-mage. There we go. And now we've got to wait 40 seconds for the game to go. So, yeah, definitely Wolves Express. They've got very big team fight potential. And I like the fact that I think with the four of like the Witch Doctor, Tidehunter, Magnus, and Lion can all four sort of roam as four and definitely have the potential to get some solid kills while giving the space to the Anti-Mage. And then after that, you know, 20-25 minute mark, Anti-Mage got that the Battle Fury, Manta, maybe plus another item. He can definitely join the fights and then add to it there.
Yeah, I mean, I think if this goes late, Wolves Express should definitely have this with the amount of teamfight they have on top of the Anti-Mage, who in general will outbeat a Drow in the late stages of the game. It's a more mid-range focused hero.
Okay, hopefully everyone is ready to go. And I'm going to run through the... Let's go with Wolves Express on the Radiant side. We've got Hurley, who's going mid on the Magnus. In the offlane, we got Triton on the Tidehunter. We got Citizen 5 running on the Anti-Mage, safe lane Anti-Mage. And Captain King on Witch Doctor, not on the Lion this time. And then we got Breenan on the Lion. And Moo comes out from Apefroggy. What about the Dire side?
On the Dire side, on Jim and the Four Darklings, we have Ape Froggy on the Spirit Breaker in the offlane. We have Afwas Middle on the Puck. Tyrande on the Bane. YDF on the Mirana, who are both going to the bot rune. And we have Doc Sportello, Wow I Have Team, on the Drow.
Let's just call him Doc. So this could actually be an aggro tri lane coming from Jim and the Four Ducklings. By their position, we've got the Bane hiding into this, hiding in the Roshan pit for now. Do they scout anything out here? It looks like there definitely is going to be a fight. We've got to remember, the Mirana has an arrow set up by the Bane if need be, but it might be kind of obvious. So, Citizen 5, probably wanting to take the rune, will have to be really careful. Is Bane going to come out now? Yeah, he's going to come out. He's got the Nightmare. He's got a Nightmare. But is Breenan going to take it? Breenan's going to take the arrow. He's not. He doesn't take the arrow for the team. Captain King trying to keep the Nightmare off, but Citizen 5 is going to go down. He's down. There's First Blood. Tyrant drawing First Blood by killing Citizen 5 on the Anti-Mage. Very nicely set up. The combo already coming into fruition.
Yeah, something I quite liked was Dire's Ward was placed in the camp, so it can see into the river a lot more than this spot here can.
Yeah, very clever.
And it's something that was very easy done as they're just walking into the Roche pit.
So yeah, nicely done there by Jim and the Four Ducklings, drawing First Blood, and that early gold for the Bane is going to be nice. Smoked up now, they're going to loop round and try and find Triton.
Yeah, the path was drawn out there. Although the Tidehunter is actually standing a little far forward.
I think he's going to be in the top of the smoke. His smoke's revealed. Nightmare arrow coming in. It's not the longest range arrow in the world, but I think there might be enough damage. A lot, especially with the Drow. Yeah. So Bane once again picking up the kill, second kill of the match. Only 1 minute into the game. Things off not great.
The Tidehunter could have possibly done a little bit better. Then he skilled after he got arrowed into Anchor Smash. But I feel if he had that Levin shell early on, that might have been enough damage to proc the purge, and he may have been able to escape.
Very maybe, but things definitely looking up for Jim and the Four Ducklings. Eep Froggy trying to harass maybe this Breenan. Wants to get as much farm as he can, but these three range creep for him, it's not really doing him any favours. He's going to push under the tower for the Radiant. Puck, actually, let's get these last hits up. Puck, definitely you'd expect to win this lineup, but currently it's fairly even. Hurley doing a nice job here. He's got his bottle coming towards him now on the courier after having been able to spam Shockwave and get a few last hits that way.
Yeah, I think he's very lucky to get a bottle that early on. The fact he didn't go for a stout shield, I feel this Puck could have been playing possibly a little bit more aggressive to start with, pressing him out a little bit more, but yeah. Now he's got that bottle, I can't see the Magnus being pushed out of lane that easily.
No. I mean, Puck generally is one of these high, he's got high starting damage, which can make a pretty strong mid hero, especially against melee heroes, who she can right click down and then, if need be, use some magic spells. Hey, Froggy, pretty far up here. Is there going to be a Hex? In fact, this is very strange. The Lion has not leveled Hex. This is unusual to say the least. Normally you want level 1 Hex, then you go Earth Spike, and that means you've got two disables at level 2, but opting not to go for that, maybe preferring the Mana Drain to stop the Spirit Break of any chances of sort of charging away.
I wonder if the Spirit Breaker has checked Captain King's inventory, and if he did, he'd see that there's still a ward there. So this would be able to tell the supports that there's no ward top, and so basically they have free roam onto the Magnus from top. Yeah, they'd have no vision at all seeing that gank move in. And there is still a smoke on the Mirana. And in fact, I think the Bane is pinging out that they want to go behind.
So yeah, Bane and Mirana. I think they need to be a bit more active. They did well early on, got 2 kills, but I think they need to keep this momentum up if they really want to succeed. Maybe the Anti-Mage will be a likely target. Spirit Breaker getting stunned up now. Is this going to be enough? No. He's not banning creeps, so the castle not going to do anything.
Mirana has missed the arrow in mid, unfortunately. That was a good try.
Yeah. I mean, if you've got this Bane set up, I feel like you should definitely try and use it.
Yeah, I don't feel the Drow really needs much support in lane, because the Tide is playing very safe now after dying early on.
Yeah. Tide does have his boots now, and he's got a lot of regen, so I guess if he does see the fact that Mirana or anyone else is not there, he can push up and at least guarantee himself some experience, if not the last hits that he would preferentially like. But there is always the Ancients to go to, which actually have been warded up by the Dire, so they'll see if he does end up going towards those. Another smoked up Mirana, looking to fire an arrow mid. Still without the Bane set up, but maybe she's confident enough. She can get the angles right onto this Magnus. I think Puck needs to sort of right click him down a little bit, which she's doing. Hopefully get him in a range where they can kill him if they land the arrow. The arrow comes out. No, it's just going to hit a range creep. That's one more CS for the Mirana.
Yeah, there's no way that's getting denied now. But yeah, I mean, the Bane is getting some XP and is trying to deny Tide the XP with all these pulls that's happening, but I feel like the ganks need to be coming out, because playing against an Anti-Mage, you just need to keep the pressure going all throughout, just so that if they rotated down bot to try and get the Witch Doctor or something, but
yeah, it's just pressure applied. I mean, 26 last hits now, which is even to the Drows, but we know that once Anti-Mage gets that Battle Fury, he can blink around the jungle camps and just farm twice as fast as any other hero, really. The Mirana is now back top. Bane looking for this arrow set up with the Nightmare. He gets, yep, there's the Nightmare. In comes the arrow, dealing a fair bit of damage to Triton, but it's not loads. But there is the Silence, so he doesn't have Anchor Smash. We just need a Brain Sap. Brain Sap, Kill Steal. No, one more right click comes out from the Mirana, and it's enough. So yeah, once again, this combo proving
very
strong.
Puck has jumped onto the Magnus mid. The Dream Core is
Dream Core and Hurley goes down. So it's 4-0 now. Jim and the 4 Ducklings definitely dominating this early game with kills, but I don't normally like to bring up the graphs too early, but looking at this XP and gold, yep, both in the way of Jim the 4 Ducklings, 1500 gold and 2000 experience.
I mean, this is a lot of kills going towards Jim the 4 Ducklings, but I have a feeling Wolves Express don't really mind this too much, because the Anti-Mage is sitting completely untouched still.
It will be interesting to see. I think, yeah, once the team fight comes online with the RP and the Witch Doctor ulti and stuff, it'll be interesting to see whether they can actually pull this back. We got Mirana once again rotating, some harassment coming onto Hurley. Hurley's going to have to watch out for this arrow. Hopefully the Tidehunter has told him that he's missing. Look at this arrow. Hurley standing really still. But is anyone there to follow it up? It was a good arrow, but the puck's too far away, and the Mirana doesn't really want to leap down into tower range, because there is the RP available. Well, still keeping them scared, keeping them on their toes. Even if you don't land the hooks, it's still a threat. Dream Coil up in 10 seconds, and I think that could be easily another kill onto Hurley.
Oh, it looks like they're pinging out the Tide. They know where he is, I think.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, there is no... The Mirana's sat mid, so I don't think they're going to be able to get the kill on this Tide.
Yeah. Spirit Breaker. Yeah. Oh, no. It's going to be it. Triton TPing back home just to Just a little bit afraid. Yeah, here's the dream call and the waning rift. Oh, the RP is used. This is going to be enough for the tower damage. He needs to skewer. Yes, no. Oh, the phase shift is going to be in time. And the aggro of the tower. So nicely done there by Puck.
Hurley did very well there with the RP. He was very unlucky with the phase shift from Puck. I thought he managed to turn that around. But
That was very close. So well played by both heroes, but the elusiveness of Puck being played by this Aphwa's middle. Just coming out on top.
And this is another, on top of the 5 kills they already have, another huge amount of gold going towards the Dire team with the fact that top tower has now fallen. And this is quite a big blow for Tide, as he's probably being not really feeling that safe there now. He's can't really push up too far with no vision. You might just have to resort to going and stacking ancients and jungle camps and farming that way.
It's pretty dangerous now, the fact that the tier 1 tower's down. If they get this mid tier 1 tower as well. Oh, there's a hex up onto Aphwa's middle, and then the ice, this carapace, but there's a charge onto Hurley. He's got to be really careful here now. Aphwa's middle is pretty low, waning rift used. Is the Spirit Raker going to come through with this? I think probably not. He is, he's going in. He's got level 6. I think this is a kill if he's not careful. There's no RP, just the lightning shockwave, but the bottle, is it going to be enough to keep him alive? Breeman coming in as well, but no, he gets killed off by YDF on the Mirana. So it wasn't the Magnus going down, but the Lion goes down again.
Yeah, I mean, unfortunately for the Spirit Breaker, the 17% chance to bash was actually showing off there, unlike normal.
Well, Captain King maybe in a little trouble. Yeah, there's something I was going to mention earlier, if there's nothing more happening, although it looks like there might be some level 3 Mirana only, but if she lands the arrow, that's going to be enough. Spirit Breaker charging onto this anti-mage, I think probably just to get bottom. Arrow coming in, it's going to hit Hurley, he's dead. Lovely arrow. Aphwa's middle just needing to orb in and use Waning Rift, and that's another kill. Level 10 Puck now, snowballing out of control with 2500 gold in the bank is going to be his Puck, and then some more.
So this is something, this is one of the downfalls of the Roaming Mirana, as she is level 3. I mean, both the supports on Wolves Express, even though they are level 4, they still do have that leveled advantage on top of her.
Yeah, but also the anti-mage is only level, well, when I last checked was only level 5, but it's now level 7, but the Drow, level 8. So Drow does have a little bit more advantage, and being a more mid-game orientated hero, it's pretty good. This is an invis rune picked up by Bane. With this level 3 brain sap, he does a lot of damage just to finish off an arrow target if he gets caught out.
I think you might have seen the lion move into the jungle, and it looks like they're going to try and hunt him down. Especially with the Spirit Breaker there to turn and charge, and he does have his ultimate up, although he doesn't have the mana just yet.
No, so going to leave it at that.
Oh, they might run into Captain King though, who's coming down to the mid lane.
Yeah, he might make an escape if he's lucky enough, but this ward is going to spot him out. But does YDF want to go in? There's no Bane, just a blind arrow. Is it going to hit anything? Oh, that was very close. Captain King, I think, just dodged that by chance, but that's enough. Ah, then we missed a kill. Must have been a gust. No gust used at all. Oh no, this was bot lane. I completely missed that. That was Spirit Breaker getting the kill.
Yeah, he got the mana, he just ran straight onto Lion, I think, got a few bashes.
Used the Nether Strike as well.
This Magnus is, he's backed off now, but he's playing very far forward, which is quite dangerous against a team as far ahead as this, and Puck with the Blink Dagger now.
It's so hard. I mean, what do you do in this situation? I guess just pray and hope that your anti-mage is getting a lot of farm, but he's doing okay, but nowhere near as close as this Drow is, and the Puck even has more last hits than the anti-mage at this stage, plus kills to her name. And it looks like they've finally had enough of this anti-mage. With the blink ready and the level 2 dream call, this might be enough to shut down this anti-mage if need be. And look at this. Spirit Breaker charging in, trying to get onto Captain King, not level 6 yet. And the blink silence onto Captain King, he's going to go down real quick. There's a TP support, Citizen 5 blinking into the tree line, I think. And Ape Froggy might be in some trouble here. If they can get a kill here, this is going to be pretty big. There is a Ravage available, but Nightmared up. Nicely done. RP only onto Apefrog. He's going to... No mana for Skewer, actually. Actually, there was mana for Skewer. And a 3-man coil. That's going to be lots of damage coming out now. And Magnus does go down from the Bane. Triton, a lot of trouble here, but Citizen 5 Yeah, no ults. He's got no mana. But maybe he did earlier on. So, a little bit of grief, and here comes the arrow. Hits onto Citizen 5. Eat Froggy, he's got Nether Strike. He's going to use it. And the stun, the silence is enough to blow him up. This team fight coming out from Gym 4 Duckies is really good. Triton, is he going to go down? Yes, the Maledict was used. Is this going to be a team wipe? No, because Lion is still alive after dying recently. But, man, yeah, 14 for nothing. Gym and the 4 Ducklings doing work here. Running rings around Wolves Express, and while all that was happening, Drow free farming away, hitting this tower, 2600 gold. Things aren't looking good for Wolves Express.
And what's really nice is while they were there, Jim, the Dire team have left a ward back down bot, so if Antimage does decide to go back down there, you can see exactly what he's going to be doing.
That's 5 urn charges for Spirit Break already. Oh, there's here's the Bane with the puck. It pings out. Can they see him? They can't see him. They're just waiting by the secret shop, expecting possibly some rotations. Nothing.
I thought with the Anti-Mage getting all this free farm, who's being charged on now by the Spirit Breaker, I don't think Spirit Breaker should be able to kill him, although there's a bit of damage being done. But the Anti-Mage only has a Perseverance towards his Battle Fury at 14 minutes. I mean, he does have treads, but I feel like he should be a lot closer than he is.
He's died twice, only got 61 last hit. I mean, look at this Drow farming like Madman. Or Madwoman. He's got 100 last hits for 14 minutes. I mean, she has been in the jungle for a lot of it.
Oh, Spirit Breaker never striked onto the Anti-Mage.
Anti-Mage in a lot of trouble. No, he's fine. He's got a blink. Got a blink away. That's a very short range blink. But it should be enough. There is the urn ticking him down. Put on your heal, Anti-Mage. Oh, not Anna. Captain King, even, on the Witch Doctor. Did he accidentally pull the creep wave? Because this is not going to favour Anti-Mage in the slightest. Another negative urn charge being applied.
Oh, I kind of like this pickup from the Drow. Is on top of her mom, she now has a Shadow Blade. So they're so far ahead, and she's so powerful at the moment. She can probably go around and get a solo kill on almost anyone apart from maybe the Anti-Mage, although with it's only a level 1 gust, she might be able to burst him down that quick enough.
Yeah.
It looks like there's going to be another fight down.
They're going to try. This is an illusion, so whether they blow RP on it now, it's clearly an illusion. They won't do anything about it, but it is vision, and they see this TP coming in by Tidehunter, but once again has no mana. For Ravage, does have 8 stick charges, so that is enough, but that's all. So he's going to be really careful here, being very aggressive without the Spirit Breaker charging onto Bremen. He's going to bash 1, bash 2, bash 3, and just the Nether Strike, not quite on cooldown yet, gets hexed up, but the 3-man coil, but the Ravage does come out. Is there going to be an RP? Nope. He's got Fiend's Gripped up, and that's going to be the end of Hurley. So that is the first kill on the Morana is happening, but Citizen Vive going down, and then the Brain Sap is enough to finish off the Tide for a 5-man wipe by Jim and the 4 Ducklings. So although they lose the Morana, I'm pretty sure they're happy to take that trade. Maybe they were wanting to go for a no-kill game, or no-death game even. But
I think with this they can probably actually pressure the Tier 2, maybe even take it now.
Easy, especially with the Drow, though it looks like they're backing off maybe. Run out of mana.
A full Yule's coming out onto the puck now. Wow. I don't think there's the Dire's so far ahead at the moment.
Game is hard.
This is also, I suppose, one of the downfalls of an Anti-Mage. Of he needs his items. I mean, perhaps seeing all this early fight, Battle Fury may not have been the best way to go. Maybe building a bit more tanky items, like perhaps an SMY and a Vlad.
Oh, so Triton tanks an arrow, but I don't think they're going to do anything up from this. Dreamcall is down for 13 seconds, and they have no Bane, has no mana, but it does have a 4 staff before boots. Oh, just picked up boots though, to be fair.
Drow Ranger, after recently buying a Shadow Blade, is now sat on 2500 gold once more.
Man, this is scary. And XP, it's 1400 XP lead. Oh wait, 14,000 even.
It'll be interesting to see if she notices that the Blue Rune of Justice is up top.
Just go kill the whole team in one go. Oh, Puck jumping in, but I don't think it's going to lead to much.
Not feeling that brave to jump on all three on his own.
With the Staff of Wizardry, do you think she's going to pick up a Dagon?
Oh yeah, but I think it's I can't really see what else it'd be building apart from maybe an Aghanim's, but when you're ahead, all the other people, the lions are level 5 and stuff, the amount of burst damage you have, I mean, the anti-mage only has one level of spell shield.
Shadow Blade up by Drow Ranger, I think this is going to be enough for a kill with the Mom active as well, and the jump in by Puck. Easy kill, but I think Puck wants some more maybe. Yeah, with the DD rune, I think this might be an easy kill. Oh no, got to be really careful here with the Maledict. Breemum using the Hex, well, the Earth Spike it was. Anti-mage comes in and ends the Wicked Six Streak for 617 gold. That's one more component of his Battle Fury. Puck throwing her life away. Or his life, I think it's his, isn't it?
Yeah, I believe so. Yeah, I mean, that was a Puck just getting a little bit too carried away there. I don't feel it was worth risking all that just to try and kill a Witch Doctor, but...
Speaking of Witch Doctor, we have yet to see a Witch Doctor ulti.
Drow is now set on 3600 gold. It's going to be interesting to see what Shia buys, and she's jumped onto
Lion,
the
Lion. Lion, one more right click and that's going to be enough. Let me get my arrows back. She could just pick up something like a... I don't know, would you get like a Battle Fury? No, not Battle Fury, a Butterfly even.
She might be going fight. She might be just trying to go for perhaps a BKB so she can fight through Ravage or something, just to play it safe. It's like, we're ahead. There's no point in trying to throw this away now. Just play it safe and last through these fights.
I love this zoom out view. I need to use this more. You can perfectly see the whole of the Dire side lined up, hiding in the tree with just the Puck showing. But equally, there is backup from by the Radiant. But look at this Dire Ward. It can see everything.
Yeah, the Dire have been very good with their warding. It's not been like in places you'd expect wards to be, like the one that is behind the tier 2. And just granting so much vision, they can see the Tide, who still doesn't have a blink yet, is about 500-600 gold off. Witch Doctor's got wards on him, but can't seem to... walk out and place them, although they've seen the sentry on top of the hill now. They're pinging
still,
out madly.
Still two more wards here. And here. Oh my god, the drawing's bad.
Drow was still on 4400 gold.
Is it rapier? It's gonna be a rapier.
We're ahead, we're not gonna lose this. Oh no, she just wanted to buy a full SMY.
Okay. How boring. Come on, Drow. But this, look at this Roshan fall. It is falling real quick.
Yeah, Aegis on Drow. I mean, even if they put it on perhaps the Puck.
Nah, they're giving it to the Drow. I mean, look how hard Puck is hitting.
Puck is also only 100 gold off of the Dagon now. But it looks like they just want to pressure the fight straight away with seeing where all the supports are rotating. Dire's
top tower is under siege. Magnus. Magnus almost has blink.
Anti-Mage does have his Battle Fury now, but it depends. If they can hold out with using things like Ravage and RP and they just don't lose these high ground towers, I mean, there's a chance that Anti-Mage can come back into this.
Imagine if they kill the Drow. Oh, Hurley in a lot of trouble here. No, he's going to be fine. The Earth Spike missed on Aphra's middle. I think they've got to give up this tower. They don't want to fight. They can fight high ground. I think they kind of have to fight high ground. Spiritbreaker is charging in from a long way away. Is he going to go? No. And he's actually gone for a crit. The mini crit for now, anyway.
That's quite interesting because he's not actually doing a great deal of damage at the moment.
Arrow comes in, Breemum, he's in a lot of trouble. One brain sap and it might be enough damage. No, Fiend's Grip is being used just to cure it. Triton, he's got Ravage, he uses it. RP is used on Ape Froggy. Hurley getting out and the Anti-Mage managing to get out as well. So there's only one casualty, the Lion. Witch Dolty, pretty big, but it's not going to do enough damage. The move speed because of the Spirit Breaker is more than enough to get them out safely.
I think Jim and Four Darklings there, they got a kill, forced out a buyback that did nothing. Oh, and the Puck's jumped in again.
Arrow, is it going to hit anyone? No, hits the barracks.
Still have Aegis on top of the Drow. I feel she can probably just walk onto high ground.
YDF in a lot of trouble here. They needed a finger there. They just needed a finger and she would have been dead. Ape Froggy actually backing off. I think they're going to back off and reset for now. No? With the urn charges, they might have enough to just keep going. They don't have Fiend's Grip, but there is no RP. There is no Ravage. There is no Witch Doctor ulti.
Perhaps what they might do is wait these 20 seconds for Dream Coil, then run Drow onto the Tigan on the tower, and then surprise them with the next Dream Coil.
Oh, Hex up onto Puck, but a lovely Gust catching two here. Aphra's middle is taking a lot of damage from the tower, but uses the Dream Coil. Yule's Scepter is going to be enough to keep him safe, and the Urn Charges. The Plenta. Oh, there's only one Urn Charge now left on Spiritbreaker, so. I think Wolves Express are doing a pretty good job here, actually. Arrow is going to hit Captain King. He's gone. He is dead. Misses up the hill, but two hits, and Doc is absolutely wrecking on this Drow Ranger. With the Mom active, though, taking a lot of tower hits. They're going to try and get a Skewer back. Skewer back by Hurley is going to hit no one, and the Yules keeps him up. And Drow Ranger is just going ham. She's got this Aegis. She can. She used Shadow Blade to try and get a bit of extra damage, and Hurley is out. That's three down now. There's no Fiend's buybacks. Fiend's Grip onto the Anti-Mage. This is his death as well.
Blown up. Ultra kill for the Drow.
I think this game's over, man.
Yeah.
What can they do?
Yeah, the GG is called.
23 minutes in.
26 for two.
How come we keep casting these, like, short games where there have been other ones? But anyway, stay with us, guys. Well, that was actually, let's do a little recap of that game. I mean, even though the teamfight potential by Wolves Express was there, it just wasn't really much.
Yeah, I don't know what it was, but it didn't seem like the Anti-Mage was actually farming as well as I felt he could have been doing.
I don't know, he had like about 55 last hits at 12 minutes or something, which is okay.
I mean, I suppose the two early deaths really damaged him quite early on. But, yeah, I mean, the team fight didn't really... The pressure just applied, just kept going and going, and seemed to keep them through.
Yeah, so that was the first game of tonight. Jim and the Four Ducklings easily taking the win there against Wolves Express. Wolves Express are still in the tournament. This is double elimination, so this was the upper bracket, so they're going into the lower bracket now. And up next, I believe we have Team Logo versus RGS. We haven't seen RGS play yet, because they got a sort of free pass due to Animememe not turning up. So thank you, Luke, for staying by, and we're going to do the next one, yes?
Yep.
Hopefully that'll be a little closer, but well played to both teams. We'll be seeing more of both of them later on. So stay tuned, we'll have more coming.